Some of my idols growing up, I always loved KRS-One. You can see some of the similarities in that energy that came with The Bridge Is Over. And they would say Manhattan keeps on making it, Brooklyn keeps on taking it, Bronx keeps creating it, and Queens keeps on faking it. I'm from Queens, man. It was hard to like that shit, but I liked it. I decided I'd be an entrepreneur before I even had any success in music. I was hustling with intentions to earn enough money to not have to hustle anymore. Whew, I've been blessed. I've had the kind of career that allowed me to have 2 albums go diamond, selling over 23 million records, and then for me to continue to actually put out projects that creatively kept me content. You know, May 2000, I got shot, so I was dropped from Columbia Records, and then I came back, and the next deal was done in 2002 with Eminem and Dr. Dre. After the actual shooting, I went through a process. A lot of people won't be honest because their image would be up. They've been through the actual experience, but I went through a portion of me actually being afraid and experience because I was hurt physically. I was hurt bad, so I was afraid and I wasn't comfortable with being afraid. And the only time I wasn't afraid is when I was actively involved in actually looking for somebody connected to it. You look at the bushes, when I see the bushes, I look through the bushes. The paranoia from the experience of actually being hurt heightens your senses to everything, the possibilities of things happening. It shifted me. It's either when you get hurt that bad, either your fear consumes you or you'll become a bit insensitive. And you'll start to approach the problem instead of run from it.